What's up, everybody? How's it going? Are we ready to go? I think we're ready to go. Okay, everybody, welcome to Triple Threat Part 2. This is our second time in the series for Triple Threat. What you guys can expect to see, it is cardio, upper body, and core. So three different body parts that we're gonna be focusing on today. You're gonna see each one of the exercises at least three different times, thus the name Triple Threat. Plus also we have three different blocks. Now each exercise is gonna last for exactly 1 minute, and then we go right back to the top of our pyramid. So we're gonna start with cardio. We're gonna go directly into upper body strength. Then we're gonna take our weight into your core strengthening. Then we go right back to the top of that pyramid. So think cardio, strength, core, cardio, strength, core, cardio, strength, core. We move on to the next block. It's gonna take us about 30 minutes, a little bit over, to finish today's workout. I'm pretty excited about it. Hopefully you're excited about it. I see a lot of us are kind of starting to come in. Hello, hey Stacy. It's gonna be great. So a couple things that you're gonna need in order to be successful for today's workout. You will need external resistance. So if you have dumbbells, now's the time to go ahead and grab onto them. If you do not have dumbbells, then you can grab onto something else that can give you external resistance. I always suggest water bottles or water jugs are gonna be a great idea. You can even fill up your water bottles with sand if you have them, great. Or if you just wanna try to mock it with just your body weight, that's totally fine too. So you have lots of opportunities here. We're just about a month into quarantine, guys. At this point, we gotta get something else besides for our body weight. But you know, we can always work it out with our body weight as well. Okay, so if you haven't already, go ahead and find your clear area. I'm gonna grab onto my towel, my hat, and then we're gonna get going, y'all. By the way, if you like today's music, feel free to find it on Spotify. Basically everything as far as like my playlists are concerned are found on Spotify, so find me on Spotify. And if you would like to do this workout again, it's gonna be on my story for the, for a full day, 24 hours, and then it'll go away, but I will also be posting it on YouTube. So lots of different opportunities to play here, guys. All right, so without further delay, let's go and get started, shall we? Go ahead and find your nice little play area. I'm gonna turn up the music now. We're gonna start with our warm-up, this kind of opening up the body. Here we go. Okay, bring your feet so they're a little bit wider than shoulder distance apart. Create two fists off to the sides. You're gonna start to roll out the wrists here. Just kind of rolling it out here, guys. We will be on our hands, so this is a good opportunity for us to kind of get some joint mobility. Now take the head, start to roll it over to one direction. Then I want you to reverse that direction. Head to the other side. Then again, roll the neck. Then roll it back. Let's go into the shoulder. Start giving me some shoulder rolls. Give me four on the way back. This is two, three. Now reverse that direction. Take it all the way forward. Four times. Three, two. Now you place your hands on top of your shoulders. Give me some elbow rolls. We're gonna roll them back four times. Big exhale, pull the belly button in towards your spine. Reverse your direction, pull it forward. Two more. One more, then give me a nice little arm circles on that right side. Reverse your direction, take it back. Left arm, same thing, take it forward. Now take it back. Let's go into the torso. Start to roll in one direction. Reverse that direction, take it back. Let's do that again. One direction, not the band, other direction. Go into your squats for me, guys. Take it out, down and up. You're gonna simply bend those knees, push your hips behind you, keep your heart nice and lifted. We will be doing some cardio here, so it's a good idea to get that lower extremities working as well. Then we're gonna add on to this. You're gonna give me nice little hip circles as you stand. So take your squat, open up the hips. Squat and open. We're gonna do that just four more times, everybody. This is one. Makes two. This is three. Squat overhead reach looks a bit like this. Waist squat, hands high. Now as the hands come above your head, throw your hip bones forward. Throw your thumbs towards the back of the room. Four more. This is one. Makes two,
This is three. Hold it at the very top. Hold it here. Exhale, reach down for your toes.
Inhale, reach back up high to the ceiling. Do that again. Down to the toes, up to the ceiling. Two more. Down toes, up to the ceiling. One more time. Hold it here. Tuck the chin to the chest. Shake the head no. Nod the head yes. Bend the knees, hands to the floor, hop both feet back. Press your hips to the ceiling. Begin to pedal the heels down towards the floor, opening up the hamstrings and the calves here. You're gonna give me eight more. Give me eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. Both heels low, hop both feet forward, stand all the way up. And give me some quick feet here, guys. Quick feet, quick feet, quick feet. Keep those arms in guard. We're gonna make our way into your very first cardio segment. Your first cardio segment, you're gonna have three jumping jacks, two side shuffles. So give me my jumping jacks right here. Hold on to your jumping jack. Now once again, we have 1 full minute of work. You keep going, take a look. You're gonna have two jumping jacks, a shuffle, two jumping jacks. It's actually three. We're gonna do three jumping jacks. Four, three, two, here you go, guys. Three, two, one, shuffle. Three, two, one, shuffle. Three, two, one, shuffle. Three, two, one. You're 15 seconds in. Come on. Slowly the breathing needs to start to change. Become a little bit more challenging as we take deeper and deeper into this motion. Side shuffle. Three, two, one. 30 seconds. You got it. Now as you take that side shuffle, can you get this a little bit lower for me? Get a little bit lower. Shuffle, go. Shuffle, go. Now you have 15 more seconds. You're about to quickly grab onto your dumbbells. It's a curl overhead press. You keep going. We have about 8 more seconds. You're gonna grab onto those bells. Looks a bit like this center. You take the curl press. Come with me right here. Curl, press. Arms low, pull, push. Now notice, as I take the push above my head, my shoulders go down, while the weights go up. Keep it going, guys. Pull, push, repeat. Now I want you to imagine you're in a narrow hallway, right? Everything should be super streamlined. Straight up, straight back down. Again, pull, push. Keep it going. You're more than halfway there. Yes. Pull, push. Now I'm gonna keep the elbows super tight to my torso, controlling the motion as it comes up and right back down. For about 15 more seconds. Okay, you keep going. Here's your next exercise. Keep going, guys. You're gonna come into a high plank position. Opposite hand will tip to opposite shoulders. You'll come down, punch forward. All right, come on down for me. Opposite hand to opposite shoulder. Take it to a low plank. Punch, alternate your side. Walk it back up to a high plank. Opposite hand to the opposite shoulder. Take it down, punch it forward. Now here's the challenge. How stable can you be in your high and also your low? If it feels like you're doing a lot of rocking and rolling, try to take some of that rock and roll out. You have 30 more seconds here, guys. Keep on moving. It's a tap, tap, walk down, punch, punch. Walk it up. Take it right back down. Punch, punch. Now here's the interesting thing. After those shoulder presses, right now shoulders should be lit up. So coming from the high to the low position should start to feel more challenging. You have less than 10 seconds. Give me one more. You're about to come back onto your feet. In 3, 2, and 1 on your feet. Three jumping jacks. Side shuffle. Three jumping jacks. Side shuffle. So this is our second round. First exercise. Allowing the heart rate to get up a little bit higher here, guys. Get to the side. 3, 2, 1. Get to the other side. Allow the heart rate to slowly start to increase here. Now we reach the halfway marker, and it should feel like you have maybe about 30 seconds left inside of you. for this particular motion. Come on. Now, I don't know about you, but I can probably get a little bit lower on my side shuffle. We have time for one more, guys. 3, 2, 1, grab onto your dumbbells. Go right to your curl, push. So this is where you slow down the motion, but you keep on moving. Push, come on. 15 seconds down. Push. Now notice, I'm gonna stay as stable as I can through this one, right? So it feels like you have a lot of motion in, take the motion out. Pull your belly button, push it towards your spine. Let your core help you. You have less than 25 seconds. Here's my challenge. Can you pick up your tempo? Move it just a little bit faster. Let the music start to chase you. 10 more seconds. You're gonna come to a high plank, opposite hand, opposite shoulder, low plank, punch it forward. 3, 2, 1. Dumbbells down. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder. Punch, punch. Hand to shoulder, hand to shoulder. Punch, punch. So this particular motion is something called anti-rotation. What's anti-rotation? You keep going, but just take a listen. Anti-rotation, you're trying to take any of that rotation in your midsection completely out. So usually, if you have like a Russian twist, which we will see today, that's for you to find your rotation. This time, we're going to fight against it. You have about 20 more seconds, guys. 20 more seconds. Good, one more time for our cardio. This will be round number 3 out of 3. 10 seconds, less than 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, on your feet. 3 jumping jacks. Shuffle it out. 3 jumping jacks. Take your shuffle. Boom. Ha. Stay light on those toes, guys. Come on. Now here's the deal. You're 20 seconds in. What's going on with your breathing right now? Are you breathing heavier? Are you working at your true capacity? Or are you taking it easy on yourself? You can only be the answer to that question. You have 30 more seconds left. It should now start to feel like a bit of a struggle. You now have 20 seconds. Go. You're gonna find your longer recovery here soon, guys. 10 seconds. Ready for your strength? Where are your dumbbells? You're gonna need them. 3, 2, 1. Grab onto your dumbbells. Let's go. Push. Arms low. Up it goes. Right back down it goes. Now I like to slightly stagger my feet. Helps make sure that I take some of that tension out of my lower back. If it feels like you're arching or you're tucking, I want you to take that out. You have 30 seconds left. We have one more exercise dedicated to our core. You know, it'll last for 1 minute. And as soon as we're done, you're gonna need 60 seconds to recover before we move on to block number 2. We have 15 more seconds, come on. Push, bring it down. Up, rub that down low. You have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift your dumbbells, high plank. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder. I walk it down. I punch it forward. I walk it up. Hand to shoulder. Take it down. Punch it forward. Up I go. Tap, tap. Down you go. Now, keep on going, but here's some options. If you'd like to make it more challenging, bring your feet closer together. Or you can speed up your motion to make it less challenging. Feel free to walk your feet a bit wider, widen your base of support. The wider that base, the more stable you should feel. I'm gonna join you for your final 15 seconds. Let's hook it. Punch, punch. Less than 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, recover. Well done, everybody. Well done, well done. Okay. Block 1 out of 3. Finished. How'd you do? Do you feel proud of that work that you just put in? You're about to come in 2, block number 2. Now, once again, we're still gonna go cardio, strength, and then core. Our cardio this time, a little bit different than the first one. We're gonna have squat, cross, 2 times. We come down to the floor for a bulldog. We come right back up, crisscross, right to your bulldog. Now, your second exercise is gonna be all about your back. You can either use water bottles, water jugs, dumbbells, or I want you to focus on the contraction and use your body weight only. It's gonna be a bench over row. But for now, let's focus on the first exercise. Squat crisscross with the bulldog. 3, 2, 1. Crisscross, bulldog, bring it back up. Crisscross, bulldog. Nope. So I'm gonna stay low. No matter if it's gonna be the crisscross, or if it's gonna be the bulldog. I go right back into that start position. Control here is key. Crisscross, bulldog, crisscross. Keeping the knees bent, notice I'm gonna keep my shoulders and my elbows. Elbows fighting with your shoulders, knees in line with your hips. You're staying as low as you can. So about 20 more seconds here, guys. Take a look. This time, I'm gonna grab my water. A narrow row, then I pull it back. A wide row, narrow, straighter, pull back. Come with me. Wide, narrow, straighter, pull. Again, wide, narrow, straighter, pull. Now for that wide, elbows in line with your shoulders. Fingertips are facing straight down. As I come into my narrow, I keep it tight. Tight towards the torso, shoulders away from your ears. For the straight arm pull, I keep a straight arm reaching back behind me so that my weights go past my hips. I can reset. Now you have 20 seconds left, so I'm gonna get your tempo. Wide, narrow, straight arm. Wide, narrow, straight arm. You have less than 15 seconds. You're gonna make your way into a seated position. In this seated position, you're going to keep your legs out and in 4 times, commander rush and twist. Come on down, guys. Down to the floor, in and out, 4 times. Rest and twist, 4 times. Out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in. Again, 4, 3, 2, 1, take the rotation. So this time I am asking you to rotate, which is different than the first block where it's anti-rotation. I want the rotation to happen at the shoulders, but your hips stay nice and square. You have about 30 seconds remaining here, guys. 4 times. Now I started to pick up my pace. Feel free to join me, or if you need to, feet can come down to the floor, kick it out, alternate the side, then you can take your rotation. It's your choice. No matter what you've chosen, you have 3, 2, 1. Back onto your feet. Crisscross. Pull up. Crisscross. Pull up. And I like to call this one a slow burn. Slowly becomes more and more challenging as you go. So once again, it starts off relatively easy, becomes more challenging as you go. That's your slow burn. You have about 30 more seconds here. Breathing starts to become a bit of a luxury. I'm gonna face you on this one. Crisscross. Hold up. Crisscross. Allow the heart rate to come up higher, burning more calories as we go. Come on, kids, you have less than 10 seconds. Where are your dumbbells? You know what's next. I'm gonna grab onto the bells this time. 4, 3, 2, 1, here we go. Wide, narrow, straight arm. Wide, narrow, straight arm. In my wide row, I'm looking for upper back, right between the shoulder blades. In my narrow row, I'm looking for middle back. In my straight arm pullback, I'm looking for the back of the shoulders. So this three-way row, hitting every single section of your midsection and actually your back section. Posterior chain is what we're looking for here, guys. Back body. She's falling in love, well, that's what I can deny. 20 more seconds here, my friends. Right about now, weights should start to feel pretty heavy in your hands, but I want you to fight through it. Come on. Less than 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, dumbbells down, take your seat. 4, 3, 2, 1, twist. 4, 3, 2, 1, out. 4, 3, 2, 1, twist. 4, 3, 2, 1, out. Twist. Out. What's going on right now? You should be feeling this all the way from your rib cage down to your pelvic bone. And as soon as you twist, you should feel on the sides of your oblique. So literally, everything around here should be working hard, not hardly working. You have about 15 more seconds. We're gonna go back to the top of our pyramid for the final time. Let's go, y'all. Hey. One more, here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1, on your feet. Final time. Crisscross. Hold up. How light can you be on your feet? Option if needed. If we're not hopping today, cross, cross, walk down, walk it right back up. Lots of different ways to play here, guys. Pick the one that makes the most sense for you. By no stretch of imagination, are you competing against anybody else? This is your workout, your time. You get out of it what you put into it. We have about 25 seconds left. Final time for this set of cardio before we have our long recovery. But will you have earned it? Go. Ha. 15 seconds, guys. 10 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab onto your dumbbells. Here we go. Wide. Narrow. Reach back. Boom. Three-way row. There should absolutely be zero places for your body to hide. Right now, middle part of your back should be completely fuego. These last little sets should feel very, very challenging, but I want you to lean into the challenge, right? We came here for a challenge today. I want you to really explore it, find it, make it yours. We have less than 30 seconds. Now I'm gonna center my feet slightly. I've been noticing, I've been getting deeper into my lower part of my back, which basically just means I'm not using my core enough. Check for your body. Where are you feeling it the most? Are you feeling it middle, upper back? Or are you feeling it to the lower back? Remember your focus. 4, 3, 2, 1. Lose your dumbbells. Here we go. Kick it out, kick it in 4 times. Twist. 2, 3, 4. Come on. Twist. Out. Go. Twist. If need to, feel free to bring the feet down to the floor. Then you can bring them up for that jackknife. Again, this is your time, guys. What I do here is just directing you. Now it's up to you to be a conduit of that information. How do you want to utilize it? Let it speak to you. We're almost there. 20 seconds. Stay strong We got this. Okay. 10 seconds. Last set of twists. 3, 2, 1. Woo!
Yo, no way.
Oh my gosh. All right, y'all. We made it to the third and final block. I'm sweating like a fiend. Woo! I can tell. I am sweating out that cocktail head last night. Woo! Hopefully you guys are feeling pretty good too. Okay, our last set of cardio. Let's finish what we started, shall we? Find your space. Grab water if you need it. I know I do. Okay, quarter turns with a hop. Quarter turns with a hop. Now, this kind of brings us back to our NBA days. All of us, yes, because we're all in the NBA. So I want to see a beautiful jump shot when you hop up. Here is the exercise. Version one, quarter turn, hop, quarter turn, hop. Version two, turn, hop, reach, turn, hop. Your choice. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Reach down, up it goes. Jump shot, jump shot. Now when you make that quarter turn, I'm looking for the belly button to be facing towards the side of the room. A drop in the tail, touching down to the floor, then hopping back up to the ceiling. Guys, we've got 30 seconds left. Right now, breathing should start becoming a little bit more labored. Let that sink to you. Are you breathing heavier? Or are you hardly breathing? Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to make our way onto our back. We have a bench press with triceps in 10 seconds. You keep going. Take a look. I'm going to roll into my back. I'm going to grab my bells. I'm going to press them up. I'm going to pull them back. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Give me my bench press. Right to triceps. Bend. Right to the triceps. Now, when I come into that floor press, I'm looking for my elbows to be in a 45 degree angle. I'll do a quick quarter turn so you guys can see. Then, when I come into those triceps, elbows should be facing towards the knees. Bells too close to the earbuds. About 20 seconds here, guys. I need you to find consistency. Something that feels good to you, that you can hold on to for the next 10 seconds. We're going to take this into a hip bridge to a full sit up in 4, 3, 2, 1. Bells down, hip bridge, sit all the way up. Hip bridge, up we go. Now as we go, I'm going to give you options to make this a little bit more challenging if you want. So you get to choose your own adventure on this one. Now, incorporating this hip bridge, incorporates the lower part of your spine. Your core belt goes all the way around, guys. It does not stop at the front. It goes all the way around. Option to make this more challenging. As you sit up, bring the feet up off the floor to the tabletop. Boom. Friends, we're about to find our feet. We're going to come right back at 2 with that quarter turn with a jump shot. In 4, 3, 2, on your feet. Come on. Up we go. Quarter turn. Hop. LeBron James got another on you, baby. Woo! 20 seconds in, 40 seconds left. What's going on with your breath? Right now, if you're doing this correctly, breathing strictly from your nose, completely impossible. You should have to open up your mouth. You now have about 20 seconds left. Remember, you have options. You can slow it down, but stopping is not an option. if you need to. Boom. Right here, right? Still successful. Your eye can choose my own intensity. Have less than 10 seconds. We're about to come back onto our back. 3, 2, 1. On your back.
Oh, sorry.
Bench press, here we go.
Both is the James Hyde.
Bend. Arms down. Okay. Here's some good news. After you finish all three blocks, you literally get every single muscle group in your body. Be proud of that lift. Come on. Up. Breathe it out. Breathe it out. Now here's the note. As I come into my chest press, I'm going to squeeze the bells so that they come close together without actually touching each other. So what you're doing is there are two magnets trying to fight against each other. That's what's called your squeeze. The squeeze contraction is where all the results come from. So we have less than 10 seconds. We have time for one more. One more. Okay, lose those bells. Hip bridge. Face it. Or keep your feet on the floor. Your choice. I'm going to go right back to here. Here's some good news, guys. You've been working pretty hard, but we have only one more time through. And this is our final block. Which means you're almost done. In 30 seconds, you're going to find your feet for your final set of cardio. Oh my God, come on. 15 more seconds. 10 seconds left, guys. We're almost there. Stay strong with this. 4, 3, 2, 1. On your feet. Last one. Here we go. We're gonna turn. Last time, guys. Add that hop. Remember, as you lift up, bring those hands above your head. I know it seems trivial, but it does make a big difference. When your hands go up, your heart rate starts to increase as well. So I'm gonna say, everybody's hands up. That's what I wanna see. I wanna see your hands up. You have less than 30 seconds. Whatever you need to do at this moment to go breathless, I need you to do it right now. You have 15 more seconds. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. On your back. Grab those bells. Here we go. Push. Tricep. Chest, shoulders, triceps. You got it. Up. Bend. Up. Bend. I see you. You're almost home. Finish what you started off. About 30 more seconds right here, right now. Come on. Yes. Twenty seconds. Everything should feel on fire at this moment. As you continue to make your way closer to the winner's line. 8 seconds. We have time for one more. Up, and lose those bells. Hips up, knee sit. Hips up, boom. Can you squeeze your knees as you bring the feet up off of the floor? Lift, up. Lower back, middle core. 30 seconds. You are 30 seconds away from your recovery cooldown. But will you have earned it? That's the question. Come on. Hey, Lift. Lift. 20 seconds, actually 10 seconds. I like you. Woo! One more. Oh, that's it, guys. Holy cow. You made it. You survived triple threat. How do you feel? I think you did fantastic, yes? So cool. Okay, let's allow the heart rate to come down gently. Let's change the mood a bit. Change that mood. Okay, y'all. Come into hands and knees for it, please.
Could you be
then inhale, round the back. Exhale, length and spine. Do it again. Round the back.
Incredible. We've been working with you guys, so have a good one. I will see you soon. Bye.